CSS custom properties, also known as CSS variables, allow developers to define values once and reuse them throughout their CSS code. They offer greater flexibility and maintainability in styling web pages, simplifying the process of updating styles across multiple elements. Today, we are diving deep into the world of custom properties to learn how they function and how we can utilize them to our advantage. If you are passionate about front-end development, remember to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss out on our future tutorials. Let's begin. Imagine having a demo page featuring a simple card layout, and our goal is to give it a captivating color theme. Typically, our instinct would lead us to open the CSS file and begin adding colors and other style attributes directly to the relevant sections. However, picture this scenario. The demo page is just a tiny piece of a vast project with several design components spread across hundreds of pages written by a team of developers. Suddenly, maintaining a consistent style becomes a daunting challenge. Updating color properties, font sizes, and other CSS attributes in the future will be a gigantic task. Then comes the concept of CSS custom properties. With custom properties, we have the power to define a value once and then reuse it at multiple locations without worrying about consistency or maintenance issues. Let's explore how to effectively use custom properties to enhance our styling capabilities. To create a custom property, we start with a two-dash syntax. Let's say we want to define a custom property for the background color. We can name it --bg-color and assign beige as its value. Once a custom property is defined, we can easily refer to it elsewhere in our CSS by using the var function. From this point onward, updating the background color will be a piece of cake. We will only need to change it at a single spot, and the update will automatically apply wherever this property is used across the entire project. This way, we can ensure consistency and flexibility in our styling. Before we dive deeper, let's go through some fundamentals. As we have just covered, custom properties must start with two dashes. Any deviation from this naming convention will result in invalid syntax. Additionally, it's crucial to remember that custom property names are case sensitive. For example, BG color written entirely in lowercase is distinct from BG color starting with a capital letter. Similar to other CSS properties, custom properties must be declared within a selector block. Any attempts to define them outside of a rule set will be invalid. It's a common practice to declare custom properties within the root pseudo class, making them accessible globally. But this isn't the only option. We can also restrict the scope of a custom property by placing it within a module-level selector. For instance, if we declare the BG color property within the content box's CSS class, it can only be referenced within that specific module or its descendants. Now let's take a step further and add a colorful theme to these boxes. We will utilize the nth child pseudo class to target each box individually. Using nth child 1, we'll select the first content box among its siblings. Similarly, nth child 2 will target the second box and so forth. This is how we can define a unique color for each box while still making a single call for their application. It's worth noting that custom properties can be called before they are defined. This means that if we move all these property definitions to the end of the file while referencing them somewhere above, they will still function perfectly. Now let's move forward. Custom properties also have the capability to accept a fallback value. By providing a fallback, we can safeguard them against any oversight or misconfiguration. The var function accepts two parameters. The first parameter is the name of the custom property, and the optional second parameter is a fallback value. This fallback value serves as a substitute when the referenced custom property is unavailable or invalid. Suppose we forgot to define the BG color property for the second block. In this scenario, the light gray fallback color will automatically take charge. The same applies if there's a mismatch in the property names. Additionally, the fallback value in the var function can also reference another custom property. In this case, it first attempts to call the BG color custom property. If for any reason it fails, it will then call the fallback BG color custom property. If that one also fails, the light gray color will be used as the final substitute. There is another way of defining a custom property in CSS. The @property rule offers more flexibility by allowing us to specify a type for the property, set a default value, and control inheritance. Let's consider the following example. We can create a custom property named fallback BG color with the expectation of a particular data type. Its initial value is set to light pink, and it's specified not to be inherited. The list of valid data types for the at property rule includes color, image, URL, number, percentage, and more. If we examine the second block in our current setup, we'll notice it lacks a valid declaration for the property. As a result, the at property rule set with the initial value of light pink should come into play, avoiding any styling inconsistencies. And if we attempt to specify an incompatible data type, such as supplying a number instead of a color type value, the entire definition will become invalid. Consequently, the last substitute in this case, the light gray color, will be applied. Moreover, if we switch the inheritance to true and uncomment the parent selector, the light blue color will take precedence over the initial value. Ultimately, if all other attempts fail, the light gray color serves as the final fallback option. Interestingly, we can even set the value of a custom property using inline CSS. Just like any other inline style, this method carries a very high level of specificity. Custom properties aren't limited to just color values. They can be used with any valid CSS rule set. They provide a flexible solution, whether it's font sizes, colors, layout dimensions, or any other styling attribute. These values can then effortlessly be modified within the CSS file or dynamically with JavaScript, making it easier to maintain and update styles across an entire application. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, share it with others, and subscribe to our channel for more informative content. See you the next time.